Next question. An observer is moving with half the speed of light towards a stationary microwave source emitting waves at frequency 10 gigahertz. 1 giga 10 power 9. 10 gigahertz. What is the frequency of the microwave measured by the observer? Speed of light is given to be 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. Okay. Now, this is the case of what is known as relativistic Doppler effect. See, whatever equations we generally study in 11th and 12th, they are all belonging to the category of non-relativistic mechanics. For that matter, the Doppler effect which usually we study, we have in portions, are non-relativistic Doppler effect. But those formulas will fail if you apply them here. So how do you know that this is a relativistic case and not non-relativistic case? Very simple. If V by C is really very, very, very less than 1, then all non-relativistic formulae will be okay. But V, as it approaches the speed of, what is V actually? V is the speed of the body which is moving. Speed of the body which is moving, and C speed of light. If any body is moving with a velocity far less than the speed of light, non-relativistic formulae in general, okay. For that matter, even Doppler effect, non-relativistic Doppler effect, is okay if V, the velocity with which the source moves or the observer moves, far less than the speed of light, non-relativistic formula which you have learnt in your 11th standard, okay. But here V by C is not very, very less than 1, it is non-negligible, V by C is half. So here V by C is not to be considered as a negligible entity. V by C is close to 1, not less than 1, but close to 1. It can't be greater than 1 for anything, but it is very close to 1. So it is a relativistic case. Then what is the difference? If there is a relativistic case, you will have to consider special relativity idea. The concepts of special relativity should be involved. See, things such as time dilation should be considered. Time dilation should be involved. Or I can say in a very plain way, time is not absolute. In that case, time is relative. When V by C is not negligible, is not very much less than 1, or when V is close to C, V is close to C, what we can say? Time is, when V is close to C, time is relative, time is not absolute, right? It's enough if you know only this many ideas, otherwise it's a very, you will have to derive it, but I don't think in this context the derivation is not required. So we will directly use the formula. N prime is equal to N into square root of 1 plus beta by 1 minus beta. Just assume the formula. Here beta is V by C. So V is C by 2, it is given. This is C. So beta is half. So N prime, observed frequency, N into square root of 1 plus half by 1 minus half. N into square root of 3 by 2 into 2. You have to divide by half or multiply by 2.
n into root 3, n given as 10 gigahertz into root 3, so 17.3 gigahertz is the answer. Option 3 is correct. Okay, thank you.